Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Monday, SpaceX successfully launched their 147th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Sentinel 6B.
One, ignition, and liftoff of Falcon 9. Go SpaceX, go Sentinel 6B.
Sentinel 6B.
The booster which launched this mission, B1097, then landed successfully for the third time on the landing pad at Landing Zone 4.
Sonic boom here in the broadcast booth.
On Wednesday, SpaceX successfully launched their 148th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 694. The booster B1085 landed successfully for the 12th time on the drone ship A Shortfall of Gravitors. On Friday, SpaceX successfully launched their 149th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 678.
One, ignition, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1080, then landed successfully for the 23rd time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions. Yesterday, SpaceX successfully launched their 150th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 679.
One, engines full power, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1090, then landed successfully for the 9th time on the drone ship A Shortfall of Gravitors.
Stage 1 landing light deploy.
Earlier today, SpaceX successfully launched their 151st Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 1130.
1, ignition, engines full power, and liftoff. Go SpaceX, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1100, then landed successfully for the first time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
Related to the Sentinel 6B landing that we saw at the start, SpaceX posted some information. They said Falcon 9 lands at LZ4, marking the 500th overall reflight of a flight-proven orbital-class rocket. This coming week, we can hopefully expect to see a few Falcon launches. The first of these, the Transporter 15 mission, is currently scheduled for Wednesday 26th at 6:18 PM UTC or 1:18 PM EST. Then, later in the week, and we should see a Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 1510 mission is currently scheduled for Sunday 30th at 2:59 AM UTC or Friday 29th at 9:59 PM EST. Later the same day, and we should see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 686 mission is currently scheduled for Sunday 30th at 8:11 PM UTC or 3:11 PM EST. Heading to Boca Chica, SpaceX have been continuing to rapidly demolish Starship Orbital Pad 1. The legs have also started being demolished, with this first leg seen falling. The final leg was also recently knocked over, so the pad is now gone. Work on Orbital Launch Pad 2 continues, with the ship quick disconnect seen rolling out. Work has also been continuing with the foundations for the air separation facility. Here you can see the scale of the apartment building as SpaceX continues with construction. The new gigabase structure is progressing very rapidly. Booster 17 was rolled into Mega Bay 1 recently for scrapping. The liquid oxygen section of Booster 17 was later seen rolling out of Mega Bay 1. Earlier in the week, SpaceX had rolled out Booster 18 for Starship Flight 12 pre-flight testing. They posted pictures and said Booster 18, the first Super Heavy V3, is beginning pre-launch testing. The first operations will test the booster's redesigned propellant systems and its structural strength. During the first ambient test for Booster 18, the vehicle suffered a major anomaly that ripped it open. After the issue that happened during the ambient testing, SpaceX posted some information. They said Booster 18 suffered an anomaly during gas system pressure testing that we were conducting in advance of structural proof testing. No propellant was on the vehicle and engines were not installed yet. The teams need to investigate before we are confident of the cause. No one was injured as we maintain a safe distance for personnel during this type of testing. There was a Reddit post with a picture of Booster 18 now having been cut in half so they can scrap it. SpaceX also posted some information on the timeline for Starship Flight 12 based on this disruption. They said the Starbase team plans to have the next Super Heavy booster stacked in December, which puts it on pace with the test schedule planned for the Starship V3 vehicle and associated ground systems. Starship's 12th flight test remains targeted for the first quarter of 2026. Kiko Donchev, SpaceX's VP of Launch, posted information about Starship V3 launches and implied when we might see a Starship launch from Florida for the first time. He said the SpaceX Starship pad at 39A is really starting to take shape. The team moved and stacked the launch mount to the pad a little under 2 weeks ago. Can't wait for the first V3 Starship launch and soon after the first Starship launch from the Cape. As always, I have to say thanks to Cesar Garcia and Colleen Liedtke for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.